Daniel, ni chebe tena. Ni chebe tena na kumbu.
I mean,
she's an entry bado.
Yes, did you lose her?
Oh,
my friend. Oh, you're
now
on the entry bado.
No, your microphone is not working. Thank you.
It's very, very saddening. We are very deeply saddened to witness what we have witnessed today. Young men in their early 20s. Na wazee wawili hivi walipatikana in the crossfire. Pande huko ambassador near the archives, National Archives, moja kule. Mwingine alipatikana karibu na GPO, obviously by a stray bullet, and was very humorous. He told me that this was the first time he was participating in these demonstrations, and he was just watching to see what's going on, and then he was caught. So he said, first time and lucky. But he's alive. We've received reports today from the leadership of the hospital, and we want to thank Dr. Munene, Dr. Kutoi, and the administration of this hospital for receiving and treating scores and many, many Kenyans. We've received a report that over 200 people were brought in. Unfortunately, two of them were dead on arrival, and three died while receiving treatment. And that is one wing that we visited. So you can see, you can begin to imagine the trauma, the suffering by the Kenyan people and this nation. As we speak, we have a nation that is deeply troubled, deeply insecure. I don't think there's any Kenyan who is feeling happy today. I don't even think William Ruto himself is feeling happy, because I'd be shocked if he was. Because as a parent, how does he wake up every morning and imagine what happened? And yet, not a word since the happenings on Tuesday from the so-called government spokesperson, not a word from Inspector General of Kenya Police, or the commandant here, the infamous Bungay. I'm speaking after the president of the Law Society, Heather Thiambo, and I don't know what she told you, but in my view as senior counsel, we're going to document every case perhaps even revisit the International Criminal Court and this time talk to them about the atrocities committed against the Kenyan people by a regime which is heartless, which caused his own citizens, traitors, I mean, the committing treasonous, what was it, treasonous acts. And we are yet to be told who are the financiers of this very organic youth movement, organic, in their thousands, and they just want to claim their country back. Abductions seem to be continuing. I have here a letter that was written by the CEO of the and director, chief executive of the Kenya School of Law, Mr. Henry Mutai, when he issued this press release about the leader, Joshua Okayo, of the students doing their pupillage, doing their postgraduate course at the Kenya School of Law. He was abducted, but happily he's alive, because this morning the student was found in Murang'a hungry, very hungry, by a riverbank. You can see that style of abducting student leaders, of terrorizing them, perhaps trying to indoctrinate them. This is not the country our forefathers fought for. And I want to look at William Ruto in the face. I hope he's looking at me. And tell him to rise above himself and realize he has the instruments of power, and order the stoppage of killing of young Kenyans. It is obvious he must have given the direction, the directive, shoot to kill. Because those snipers would not have blown up the young brain we saw at the mortuary the other day. He's one of the two people who arrived here dead on arrival, because his brains were blown off. So this cannot continue. In a democracy, it cannot continue. And by the way, I want to ask William, is this a democracy or a military dictatorship? Kenyans asking all these questions. They deserve straightforward answers, and they want their country back. Kwa hivyo tunasema poleni sana kwa wote ambao wameadhirika tangu Jumanne. Jana mimi naishi karibu na Rongai, and I could hear milipuko ya risasi up to 8 o'clock. I was looking at the clock. 8 o'clock at night.
Stop all these stories. Just a minute. Please, I'm begging. What are we supposed to do? Nimeatafuta kila mahali. Hawa waliniambia nikoje mpaka kesho. Si mgonjwa nimeleta. I want just to require. Where is my grandson? Githurai.
Thank you. Kutoka Githurai, your mama. See how spontaneous. Anatafuta mjuku wake kutoka Githurai. How many others are crying like that? So the police.
Where's my grandson?
I don't even know how I can continue, because she expresses the emotion in the hearts and the minds of Kenyans. It is possible for people who have negative energy to think we may have even asked that we mama shushua kuja ali hapa. We didn't even know. In fact, I was frightened myself. I thought she was going to to throw me out. But that is reflective of the anger, the anguish Kenyans are going through. But I want to say one thing. God is on the throne. God will save our land. He will not allow this country to go down by people who want to demonstrate opulence. Young people are saying, even if you are stealing our resources, please don't vomit on our shoes, as one time Edward Clay, the famous British High Commissioner to Kenya, said. Yani munakula mpaka muna tutapikia. Vijana amesema la. And I think that for me, what has happened in Kenya is a real reawakening. The spirit of Kenyans who are saying there shall be democracy, there shall be open government.